Later, knowing that all was now completed, and so that Scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I am thirsty."
I am thirsty. Can you imagine those words from the lips of Jesus Christ? I mean, He is the Creator Christ. He created the rivers and the streams, the oceans of the world. And after 6 hours hanging on a cross, He screams out, "I am thirsty." Well, I'm standing here in the lowest place on earth. This is the Dead Sea, and across the waters there is the country of Jordan. And it really is the Dead Sea. Nothing will live here. Fish won't swim here. Not even a bird would fly across here. It's about 30 to 40% salt. And yet with all of this water, it would never satisfy your thirst. And yet there's a spiritual thirst that every single one of us have. And it's only God that can satisfy us. You see, there's a God-shaped blank in our hearts which only He can fill. And yet I see so many people trying to fill up that emptiness in their life so much today. I go into the high schools and into the prisons, and there are so many thirsty people. They don't know what is really going to satisfy their lives. I see marriages that are breaking up everywhere, and they're trying to find satisfaction and fulfillment. I see our precious young people, and they're going after drugs and alcohol or maybe some illicit sex experience. They may get some sort of pleasure for a short-term period, but it ultimately doesn't satisfy. You see, Jesus says, "I have come that you might have life to the full." He says, "Come to me, and I will quench all of the spiritual thirst in your life." Well, how different to the Dead Sea. This is the Sea of Galilee here in the north. It's a beautiful lake. It's about 25 kilometers long and about 11 kilometers wide, and it supplies most of the water here in Israel. You can drink this water, different to the Dead Sea. It just teems with life. This is a life-giving area. In the hills above Galilee is the area of Samaria. And Jesus met a woman up there at a well one time, and He said these words to her. Listen to this. "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But the water that I give him, he will never thirst again. Indeed, the water I give him will be in him a spring of water welling up into eternal life." You see, hanging on the cross, He cried out, "I thirst," so that you and I may never thirst again. He took all of the suffering on the cross so that you and I may never suffer again. The Dead Sea will never satisfy our thirsts. But this, I can go down there and drink this beautiful water. But when we come to the Lord Jesus Christ, He satisfies the spiritual thirst of our soul when He cried out on the cross, "I thirst."